And I'm going to convince you that this man would be a good president. I'm not voting to get a preacher in office. I'm voting to get a freaking president, a businessman. So I approached politics as a business.
I'm Edward Szall with Next News Network. AmpFest has brought many of the supporters, let's call them, President Trump, specifically the flamethrowers, those who were willing to fight for the president, not just in 2020, but 2016, when the Republican Party itself was fighting against him. One of those flamethrowers, and I use that term because I think it's a term of endearment for this guest, is Tana Goertz. How are you doing, ma'am?
I'm great. Thank you for having me.
Well, I think that it's an honor to speak to someone who's willing to defend the president when no one else would.
Right.
And I could be speaking about 2016, 2017, 2018. There were many times in the last 4 years where the president had few allies, but many people that maybe wanted to use his name to off of and get support. Let's talk about 2016 real quick. What was your role in the Trump campaign?
Well, let's talk about 2015, when he came down the escalator and he had a team of maybe six people. You got to win Iowa if you're going to be the president. So I was like one of the seventh, eighth campaign staffers, Corey being number one and me being right in there top 10. And so that was 2015. I'll never forget. I was heading out to a bicycle ride across the state of Iowa that I do with my bicycling team, 560 miles.
And you're a road warrior.
Right. I'm a road warrior in many ways. I'm a warrior in many ways, but road is one of them. And I was called by the campaign in 2015 to go out on national television and defend Donald Trump when he made the John McCain comments. I had never been in politics. I had never been on national news. And I went out and explained why Donald Trump said what he said. So we go way back. I mean, so 2015, there was nobody on the scene. There was not a national spokesperson. You're looking at her. And I did it, and I did it gladly. I wasn't afraid because I knew him. I knew how he thinks. I knew how he speaks. I knew what was behind his brain. And I was willing to say, hey, I know this man, and this is what he meant when the world wanted to say a different story.
Well, sure, when it came to John McCain, obviously, this has come up multiple times in the last 4 years, even after the senator's passing. President Trump was really saying what many veterans were saying. I'm a veteran. I knew the story of John McCain, and I was happy to hear President Trump bring some attention to it, because there are many POWs who did not record a tape for the enemy, okay? But the job you had, really the role, the duty that you fulfilled, it was rare. Because I remember 2015, 2016, he was the candidate. It was a joke, right? If you listen to the establishment media, it was
absolutely
a joke.
Nobody believed in this man.
People who were paying attention knew that was going to be the president of the United States.
Correct.
Did you know that early?
Oh, 100%. I bet the farm. People within the campaign, not like the first 10, but the other people, they didn't care. It was a job. See, people were like, this is easy. I'll take the check. I don't have to do much. This guy's never going to win. I can be a lazy ass, and I'll still get paid. Where I was like, get out of the way. Like, you're not, I'm Donald Trump's apprentice, whether you believe it or not. I'm the runner-up. So if you're not good, you get fired. You're kicked to the curb. Most of the people were not good, but yet they're still here. And I realized really early, people don't give a damn about their candidate. People don't give a damn about their CEO. People don't give a damn about who's putting shoes on their feet and food in the refrigerator. I'm not that person. I don't tolerate that. Saw that first on the scene. And I went, man, I'm going to have to work double time. And I did. So my role, in answer to your question, was I was supposed to be the person that warmed up the rallies, the person that brought the energy, enthusiasm, and excitement to Donald Trump. So I did that in many different ways. They wanted to use my face and name recognition, which I was happy to do, but that's not how we're going to win off of my face and my name. Hello, I'm not egotistical to believe that. I'm like, we're going to win by me pressing the flesh, and I'm going to convince you that this man would be a good president. I'm not voting to get a preacher in office. I'm voting to get a freaking president, a businessman. So I approached politics as a business. Done.
Well, I would have hoped to see more firings during the administration.
Yes.
I'll be frank. Probably share on that. Before we move on to what happened during the administration, were you around when the Billy Bush tape came out?
Yes, I was. Oh, hell yeah,
I heard, and I've read, there were tons of people in the campaign, including senior staff, that were telling President Trump to resign, to get out of the race.
Hell no. I'd cower, lie, weasel your way out of this? Are you going to man up and say, yeah, man, I said that? I was an idiot. I was this. I was that. I said it. They wanted him to quit. I said, hell no, I'll go and defend the man. I'm not going to defend his actions. I'm going to go say, hey, you know what? Most people would have cowered because most people are weak little weasels. He mans up and says, dude, I did it. I said it.
Well, most people don't know that the tape came from the RNC.
Of course.
I mean, think about this for a second.
These people.
The attacks were from the inside. Literally, the Republican National Committee were the ones that moved this tape out.
Yeah.
Well, this was reoccurring. I think during the administration, many advisors were telling the president, tone yourself down.
No, I said, turn it up. Turn it up.
What happened to the wall? I know we got some of it, but we didn't get all of it.
You know what? Here's the deal. I just said in my speech, I have a 69-page document of all of the things he did in office with obstruction, with no help from the media, with no help from the RNC, with no help from really anybody but himself and his hustle and a couple hustlers like me. And there's some good people, but there's a lot of crappy people. He did it all with all of that on his back. And what? That's what he gets, is like nobody helping him.
His base knows he fought hard.
The man barely slept. He does barely sleep. He did it all, though. And the reality is nobody gave a damn. He did it all without any help. He did it all. I get so frustrated when I have to deal with people that are saying, like, Tana, we helped him. No, you didn't. You were in his way. You were the obstruction.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you so much, man.
Thank you.
Yeah. It was a pleasure. If you enjoyed this video, you can watch the full exclusive interview and our other reports from AmpFest 2021 on nextnewsnetwork.com. That is nextnewsnetwork.com. You can also find them on Rumble, BitChute, and Odyssey. Links in the description below. God bless you.